The raft was floating swiftly toward a very beautiful country, and as they drew near, Betsy could see banks of lovely flowers showing brightly between leafy trees. But no people were to be seen at all. End of chapter 4. Chapter 5. The Roses Repulse the Refugees. Gently, the raft grated on the sandy beach. Then Betsy easily waded ashore, the mule following closely behind her. The sun was now shining and the air was warm and laden with the fragrance of roses. "I'd like some breakfast, Hank," remarked the girl, feeling more cheerful now that she was on dry land. "But we can't eat the flowers, although they do smell mighty good."
"Meh-haw,"
replied Hank, and trotted up a little pathway to the top of the bank. Betsy followed, and from the eminence looked around her. A little way off stood a splendid big greenhouse, its thousands of crystal panes glittering in the sunlight. "There ought to be people somewhere around," observed Betsy thoughtfully. "Gardeners or somebody. Let's go and see, Hank. I'm getting hungrier every minute." So they walked toward the great greenhouse and came to its entrance without meeting with anyone at all. A door stood ajar, so Hank went in first, thinking if there was any danger, he could back out and warn his companion. But Betsy was close at his heels, and the moment she entered was lost in amazement at the wonderful sight she saw. The greenhouse was filled with magnificent rose bushes, all growing in big pots. On the central stem of each bush bloomed a splendid rose, gorgeously colored and deliciously fragrant, and in the center of each rose was the face of a lovely girl.